Hello everyone, today's video will be on auxiliary position lamps. Let's imagine a common situation where we riders have stopped on the roadside for tea or breakfast, or we are waiting for other riders to join us for the ride. In this situation where our bikes are parked on the roadside and making them visible to other road users is very important. There are numerous such cases where the moving vehicles have collided with the stationary vehicles just due to the lack of visibility. Nowadays, most of the motorcycles have features like AHO and DRLs, but to use them you have to keep the keys in the on position, and with the engines off this might affect your battery, and riders may also not feel safe to leave their bikes with the keys on. So it's been almost a year I am using these lights as an auxiliary position lamp or parking lights as we all call, and I am fairly satisfied with the product, so thought of making a video of it. The product name is Powerbeam, and you will find many manufacturers with similar product who market these as bicycle headlamps. Even though this may seem to have a metal body, but everything you see on the outside is plastic. The build quality is good for its price. The packaging says it is water resistant, but no rubber sealing could be seen anywhere apart from the button which is used to operate the light. The light has got 5 LEDs inside it. The reflector and the housing both are made of plastic, which I think is good as you don't have to worry about breaking anything. The light comes with a single quick release mount, which is made up of flexible yet strong plastic, and this has a rubber grip inside it for better holding. To ensure firm grip on the surface, you get a thumb screw and a nut to fix the mount onto the desired location. And yes, the screw and nut are made up of metal. To mount the light, take the light and the mount. Slide the mount at the slot which is present at the bottom of the light, and it will fit with a click. Now these lights don't need supply from your bike's battery as they run on AAA cells. To open up the battery compartment, twist the head of the light and remove the battery compartment along with the LEDs from the body. As you can see, you will need 4 AAA cells, 2 on each side. As you can see, the light is made up in 3 parts, that is the body housing, battery compartment along with the LEDs, and finally the reflector head. So you need to fix them back in the same order. Now the light has a single button, so when you press the button once, all the 5 LEDs turn on and give a steady bright light. On the second press of the button, all the 5 LEDs starts to flash, creating a hazard light effect. I have fixed the mount at the end of the crash guard so that the light will be visible to the other road users. Now once the mount is fit onto a desired place, fitting and removing the light is a quick affair. Now time to test. As I have said, these are position lamps, so don't expect the intensity of the main headlight, but these are visible to the other road users even from a long distance. Now as you can see, these are way brighter than the DRLs and can also be visible when viewed from the side. Now we have also used this on the Dominar, not on the crash guard as the diameter was less, but on the handlebar.